in today's session, I have brought the study of first law of thermodynamics. Okay, so first of all, let's start to understand what is the main statement related to the thermodynamics first law that we will use in the study of chemistry. Okay, so now, see, in the first law of thermodynamics, according to this law, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, or the total energy of the universe remains a constant. Here you have to understand, energy of the system, it never destroyed or it never created in a new form, okay? That remains same. So overall, in the whole concept, simply we can say the total energy of the universe, that remains same, okay? Because what I have taught in the previous session, how our universe is made up of, it is made up of only of two things. One is to be of system and second is to be of surrounding. Is it clear? So overall universe total energy that remain constant, okay? But here the understandable point that energy can be transferred in the another form of energy. But the total energy of the universe that remain constant, there is no increment or there is no decrement. That you have to understand. Now, although it may undergo transformation from one form to the another form that I have written, okay, so I am telling once again, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. The total energy of the system, universe, that remains constant, but only the energy can transform from one form to the another form. Maybe was it asking forms of object, okay? Now, the mathematically, how can you show that about the first law of thermodynamics? At the initial state, the internal energy is to be denoted by U1, that you know that. For the final state, internal energy, therefore, final state, the internal energy, that is to be denoted by U2, and I have written U1 plus Q. So you see here, suppose you are having a one system, the internal energy, this is the first case, it will have some internal energy. Now, what we have done, in the second case, we have done some work on it, okay? Whenever some work it is to be done, some heat is to be evolved, so that you can say that U1 plus W plus Q also, okay? So, whenever the internal total energy, that final, that is to be U2, this will be the sum of all these terms, so that U1 plus W plus Q, that can be written, so you can write the U2 minus U1, that is equal to W plus Q, or we can write U2 minus U1, that is to be denoted by internal energy change delta U, and that is equal to Q plus W. So this is the mathematical statement which we have got in the term of work and the energy that relates to the internal energy change, and that we have to use for the numerical problem also. Here you have to understand, if delta U is equal to WAD, that the wall is adiabatic, that you know that adiabatic, that is to be used in the term of heat. Now delta U is equal to minus Q, thermodynamically conducting walls, and the U, delta U is equal to Q minus W, that shows that the system will be a closed system, that you have to understand. Let us see here few examples. Suppose here W is negative. So what you will do in that case, to delta U, that you have to put here Q minus whatever the values to be given. So that in this way you can solve here the numerical problems. Okay, so I hope you all have got it, first law of thermodynamics, but its applications are left which we have to discuss. That I am going to discuss in the next session. Till then, goodbye and have a nice day.